Now, Jelang Hospina revealed the events that followed until he lost his job at Milele FM. Now, speaking on his YouTube channel, Jelang came through and said that he was fired, but indirectly here because the first letter of redundancy came, and that is when over 100 employees were fired from MediaMax, and among them is Betty Jalo. And well, Jelang finding that his name was not on the list, it was not a surprise to him because he was confident that his show with Alex Mokide was still kicking it hard. Yeah, their show was still pumping in money to the company, and so there was no reason for him to be on the list. But behold, the second list of redundancy came through, and bam, his name was on the list. And later on, they tried to discuss with his human resource manager about the contract, where they wanted to cut down his salary, and they had already taken 50% of their salary, and he felt like his work was not being appreciated. Cheated, and that is why he was like, bro, I have to leave this job, which caught Alex Mokide by surprise after he failed to turn up at job on Monday morning. Now, that aside, what next for Jelango? Now, he has finally come through and revealed that he has gotten calls from over 8 radio stations in Kenya requiring him to work for them, but now he's just one guy for 8 radio stations. Obviously, he has to work for one, and he had to make a very tough decision, and he went forth where it all started, that is Radio Africa at Wayakwe, where he said up until now he still doesn't know which radio station he'll be working at, that is between Classic 105, Kiss 100 and Radio Jambo. But he has already held a meeting with the CEO, that is Patrick Kwako. Anyways, man, all the best to Jelango. We all knew that this guy is way more talented to stay off air, to be honest. Anyways, man, that is what's good for now. What do you guys think? Go ahead and drop your thoughts down in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Follow me on Instagram, blizzka.ke, and I'll be back with more news.